In this video, we are going to learn how the air-cooled chiller works. Commonly, there are two types of chillers. One is water-cooled chiller and another one is air-cooled chiller. Both do the same job. This means it lowers the temperature of the water coming from the AHU and then sends it back to the AHU. But there are some differences in the equipment of these two chillers. Both chillers consist of compressor, condenser, expansion valve, and evaporator. In water-cooled chiller, we use the water from the cooling tower to reduce the temperature of the refrigerant. But in air-cooled chiller, we reduce the temperature of refrigerant by using fan motor. That is the difference between the two. Now, let's see how air-cooled chiller works. Before that, we have already explained the working principle of water-cooled chiller in our channel. The link for that video is in the description. Those who need it, watch that video as well. As we have already said, there are five important equipment in air-cooled chiller. They are compressor, condenser, condenser fan motor, expansion valve, and evaporator. First, let's start from evaporator. An evaporator works like a heat exchanger. Shell and tube evaporator are generally used in chillers. Shell and tube evaporator means that the outside of the evaporator is like a shell, and inside it is coils. Inside the coil, the water from the AHU travels. Refrigerant is around the coil. The refrigerant around the coil is very cold. Being well cooled, its cooling goes to the water inside the coil. At the same time, the heat in the water goes to the refrigerant. As the heat is exchanged between water and refrigerant, we call the evaporator a heat exchanger. The boiling point of refrigerant is very low. That means, refrigerant starts boiling at very low temperature. As the heat of the water is transferred to the refrigerant starts boiling and becomes vapor. After turning into vapor, it goes to the condenser through the compressor. The water inside the coil is thoroughly cooled and again goes to the AHU. This is the process that takes place inside the evaporator. Now let's see what compressor does. After the refrigerant turns into a vapor inside the evaporator, the compressor sends all that vapor to the condenser. The compressor compresses the refrigerant well while sending it to the condenser. Due to this, the temperature and pressure of the refrigerant will become very high. Now let's see what happens inside the condenser. Condenser has coils and fan motor. All those coils are in V shape, like this. Above that, there will be fan motors. Refrigerant that coming from the compressor next travels inside the condenser coil. While traveling inside the coil, the fan motors above the condenser coil continue to blow air through the coil. At this time, the air passing through the coil removes the heat of the refrigerant that traveling inside the coil. Due to this, the temperature of refrigerant will decrease. The low temperature refrigerant then goes from the condenser to the expansion valve. The heat of the refrigerant is reduced by the air in the condenser. That's why we call it air-cooled chiller. The process of expansion valve is simple one. We have already uploaded a video on our channel showing how the expansion valve works. Its link is in the description. We have said that refrigerant comes at high temperature and high pressure when it comes from the compressor. The temperature of the refrigerant will decrease inside the condenser. So now, when it enters the expansion valve, the refrigerant comes in at high pressure and low temperature. The expansion valve expands refrigerant by spraying it. This will reduce the pressure of refrigerant. That is, the refrigerant that comes inside the expansion valve at high pressure is sprayed when it is sent out. Due to this, the pressure and temperature of the refrigerant will decrease. At low pressure and temperature, the refrigerant then enters the evaporator. The process starts again in the evaporator. It continues like a cycle. This is the working principle of the air-cooled chiller. We have uploaded videos about each equipment of chiller separately on our channel. The link for those videos is in the description. So those who need, watch all those videos. I hope this video was useful for you. If the video was useful, please like the video and share this video with your friends too. And please support and subscribe to our Zebra Learnings channel. Thank you.